Hi guys, this is my experience with the Florida Sun Water Kefir. After about 1 week, I bought it on Amazon, and I started with one batch, but after a couple of days, I was able to the grains, they multiplied, and I was able to make a second batch. There are so many grains now, I could even do 3 or 4 batches same time, but it's almost too much to drink, so I will reduce. I just was trying if there is a difference between more grains and fewer grains. Here I have the suggested amount, which is about 1/4 cup or 4 tablespoons, and here I have about 3/4 cup, almost a cup of grains, and they fermented a little bit faster, but not much faster. So you see the difference in color is almost no difference, and they both actually fermented in about 10 to 12 hours, not more. So you can see that from the grapes or the raisins which I put in, and first they go to the bottom of the jar, and after fermentation is done, they come to the top. So when they are on the top, it's ready to take or to drink. So yeah, I stir this a little bit that everything is nice and mixed. I'm using this spoon with a hole. Yeah, this is actually some other thing I wanted to show you. I bought this on Amazon as well. This is quite nice. This is very very sturdy spoon. It has a nice hole, so if you have like a thick thing to stir in a pan, so it makes it really easy to stir. That's a great thing. I can really recommend. If you want to buy this, I will provide the Amazon link to you. This is, by the way, this is a Swiss quality spoon. So this material actually is fiberglass reinforced polyamide. So this is quite safe for food, and can bear quite a bit of heat, but of course not forever in hot grease or so. So this is really good, and since it's some kind of plastic, you can use it really good for your kefir, whatever it is called. So yeah, you see the raisins are still on top, and the kefir is at the bottom. So yeah, what's also interesting about, maybe I can show you how this works. The kefir grains, they go up and down, so maybe I can show you. The water is not so clear, it's always like that, but you see a few grains, they go, especially if you tip on the jar, sometimes they go up and down. You can look like it's like a fish glass or a fish tank. They go up and down. Yeah, also the raisins sometimes. But now, yeah, I have to moved it too much probably. So here you can see on the side, when it's going up, it remains on the top for a few seconds, and then it releases some air, obviously, and it goes down as well. And that happens all the time. So that's quite interesting. If you have nothing to do, you can look this forever. Okay. So let's keep going with that. I will show you with one of the jars how I prepare a new jar. So I move this to the side. It's still taking some time because I'm not very experienced. I'm just doing this for since 1 week, so it takes quite a bit of time. I hope you're patient. So this is filtered water. I have a whole home water filter. So the good thing is it's just a carbonate carbon filter, so it doesn't filter out all the minerals, it just filters out the bad things like chlorine and all the other chemicals. So I think it's really a good thing to use, because the kefir itself, it needs some minerals and some calcium especially. And if you have a like a reverse osmosis filter, there is nothing in the water left, like no no minerals, no nothing, and so you have to add this into your kefir, otherwise it will die, or at least it will it will be too hungry to really grow. So what I do, I fill this up with this filtered water, not to the top, so we have plenty of room for other things. So what we need is a quarter cup of this sugar, brown sugar. You have to be make sure that you don't use the like bad looking sugar. I was told this one is much better because this is the original brown sugar. So if you the bad looking sugar is a little bit cheaper, but it's you can use it, but this is supposed to be a little bit better. So okay, for this is a quarter of gallon, so we need a quarter cup of this sugar. So, and the bad thing is just make sure you don't use any metal things, no metal spoons, no metal measurement things. I mean, for the to measure the sugar, it would work, wouldn't be any problem. Then to add additional like minerals, so the which the kefir really likes, I add some of the grandma's molasses. It has a lot of beneficial minerals. It's also healthy for you as well. You can eat a spoon of that every day. I've done it. It was okay, but it was not like acting like a miracle or something like that. So, and you have to make sure that all the sugar is fully dissolved, so you don't see any sugar grains anymore. So here we still have a lot of sugar at the bottom, so we can still going to prepare everything at the time that will be dissolved. So this is important. Start with the new batch at first before you pour out, or before you use the old batch, so you have time for the sugar to dissolve. But I don't, last time I put in the lemon and the raisins first, but then it was difficult to stir, so I leave just the water with the sugar and the molasses. Okay, I take this on the side so it has time to dissolve. So what I now do is I try to strain out the things which I don't need, like this raisins. So actually this could be, you could eat that. I've been told they are, yeah, still good. Even after you do a couple of batches with them, you can reuse them for a couple of batches, but yeah, I don't know. Maybe I will do it later, but at the first batches I was always using the new ones, and this is really needed for the kefir because it's a good source of nitrogen. Obviously the kefir needs some source of nitrogen. So yeah, I just dispose it. Maybe I will try it later on to use them. Also the lemon, you can use it. So here I put it on the side. You can use this to squeeze and help to give a little bit of taste. You can produce some extra taste to the drink. So I put it just on the side. So here I will puncture the lemon and try to give a little bit of extra taste. So yeah, maybe I will try one of these grapes. It's important not to touch the new batch. I mean, the old batch is not so bad, but especially for the new batch, don't touch the water. Don't touch the inside of the new batch. Not the grains, not the extra things, and have always everything clean hands and so. Okay, I tried one of the raisins. It was not so bad, I mean, but yeah, they look a little bit ugly, but yeah, they taste about the same as the kefir. The whole kefir anyway. So I have everything here. It's good. Goes down the drain. Now it's important to have something ready. I take always these Starbucks bottles, which are about 400 milliliters. It has a nice shape. You can even put it into your dishwasher washer because it has a large opening, so it will get clean, and it doesn't need too much space at the fridge. So that's also a good thing about that, because it has quite a straight shape. So I'm using always this. And of course I need a strainer and I need a funnel. Okay, this is quite easy. So if you have a firm lid, I think you can use a firm lid when you put it into your fridge. Because in the fridge it doesn't produce too much carbon oxide, so it won't explode. But I have decided to make a few holes into the lid so the air can disappear, so it won't have too much pressure. I just did a little bit two big holes. Next time I will make smaller holes. And what I will do also is, you can put in a little bit of juice to give some extra taste, or I mean, it's not bad like this anyway. Or now I'm using this lemon. I've never tried this, so maybe with a few extra drops of this lemon it will have some extra taste. So what you also can do, you can try You can taste a little bit of this and try if the amount of sugar is still okay, because when the raisins go come up, or the fruit which you use as a nitrogen source, it has still a little bit, it should have still a little bit of sugar, which is actually quite okay to give still some nice taste. But if it's not enough, you can add still some fruit juice, or just additional sugar that it tastes good. So this is, for me, it is it. I just cover it with the lid and put it in the fridge and drink it during the next 1 or 2 days. So yeah, that's it. I will continue later with that. You don't have to see, it's always the same. So we start with the new batch. Yeah, of course we have to filter out. Yeah, I almost forgot. Okay, what I have to do, I just need some kind of extra jar. So, and I have to filter out, of course, the grains which we will need, otherwise we cannot make new batch. In the meantime, yeah, hopefully the sugar has dissolved. Okay, seems like it's okay. So we can add, we can see that, so I put it on the side. So we can add a new lemon, which is important. We need a lemon to prevent some kind of fungus, and it has to be washed at least, or the better it is if you peel your lemon. So next time I will peel it, so because some of the lemons have some wax coating, and so it's better if you peel it, so you're on the safe side. So I put it in, make sure your hands are fully washed, and then I add some raisins. I have no idea how much I need. What I always did was about 1/3 of such a package. This is just great value. Yeah, Walmart stuff. You see that works pretty well. I have, if you read that in the back, it says it's cleaned by steam, so that's always good. I think there should not be too much chemical remainders with that, so that really works for me. So I have everything there except the kefir grains, so I have to filter them out, and we need about the same amount as we had for the sugar. So okay, that means 1/4 cup. So let's try. So we keep filtering. So that was previously it was 1/4 cup. I don't know if it has multiplied. Yeah, this time it seems it has not multiplied at all, or at least not much. As you see, that's 1/4 cup. As you see, yeah, it's probably perfectly about, I hope you can see that. I changed the camera a little bit. So yes, that's about 1/4 cup. Not much more, not much less. So we can right away put this back to the new batch. Or what I've seen also, what some people recommend, to wash with filtered water, or just with good water. You have to be careful that it doesn't go down the drain. Hope you can see that. Yeah, I did this also after I got the grains from the manufacturer. This can always be a good thing to wash these
grains thoroughly after every batch. So now I have to change the camera again. So now I put this into the new batch. Okay, and this is ready. So now you can see the raisins are at the bottom. I hope you can see that. It's a little bit hot. There's not much light. Okay, you see the grains are at the bottom and the raisins are at the bottom. The lemon is always on top. It's never at the bottom. So you need also the raisins are not only needed for a source of nitrogen, you also need them for you also need the raisins as an indicator if your batch is ready to use. So that's actually a two-in-one thing, which is really good. So I just can recommend this thing. The Florida Sun Kefir is a good thing. It's quite easy. It needs some time. I mean, I'm just doing this since one week, and then of course then it needs more time. When I get used to it, it will maybe I will do this in half the time, like maybe 10 minutes every 2 days or so. Yeah, it depends. I mean, I'm living in a home in Florida, and we have about 77 degrees Fahrenheit, so that makes it much faster to ferment than at other places if you have much colder or so. It depends on that. What you have to be aware, don't put it in direct sunlight, don't use any metal things, don't use any chemicals. Make sure that you rinse off all the dish soap. Keep everything quite clean. It doesn't have to be perfectly clean, but at least quite clean. No cold, no too cold temperatures. No in the fridge, it will not die, but it will stop the whole thing for quite a while. And make sure that you that you don't use hot water like above 90 degrees Fahrenheit. It's quite sensitive, but not too sensitive. I think in my based on my experience, it's much easier to cultivate water kefir than milk kefir, and it has a lot of health benefits. So I will keep probably going with the water kefir. So I hope you liked all the information. If you really like that, give me a thumbs up, subscribe my channel, and yeah, thanks for watching anyway. And yeah, this again, I hope I don't forget to provide the link for the this really nice spoon, which you can use for like fondues or everything to stir in your pan. This is a really good thing. So yeah, thanks for watching. Have a great day. See you next time.